beginning may be, and no end. Highest in the cosmos, and heaven. I have made planets and stars and their courses to go. I have made moons for the night and the sun to light the day also. I have made earth for trees and grasses to spring. Beasts and flowers, both great and small, all thrive and have my presence. I have made all of nothing for man's sustenance. And of this pleasant garden, which I have mostly goodly planted, I will make him garden for his own recreation.
I honor and love you, but I shall obey God rather than you. And while I have life and strength, I shall never cease from the practice and teaching of philosophy. For know that this is the command of God, and I believe no greater good has ever happened in this state than my service to my God. For I go about doing nothing but persuading you, old and young alike, not to take thought for your persons or your properties, but first and chiefly to take care of the greatest improvement of the soul. This is my teaching, and if this is the doctrine which attracts to you, then I am a mischievous person. But if any man should say that this is not my teaching, he is speaking an untruth. Wherefore, O men of Athens, I say to you, therefore, put me or not, but whichever you do, I shall never alter my ways, never adjust my approach to this maid, never reform till the end of my days, even if I have to die many times.
By imagination, intuition, reason, touch, opinion, sense, and name. While quite on the other hand, we find we can't begin to understand it. So to some it seems a shame to go on. But he is all things in all, and he is nothing in anything. He is often found in one thing small. Conversely, he is often missed in many.
God Almighty has made our rulers mad. God Almighty has made our people bad. For the German nobility, with typical agility, have so applied their skill that it burns the lives of the people were led astray. They feel beholden to obey. I may be just the German way, but God gives one cause.
The rise of a man.
The decline of Rome
was a natural.
An inevitable.
Men still living.
Instead of inquiring
to the inquiry,
why Rome was destroyed.
Men's filling of the void.
We should not be surprised that
God had been so tyrannized.
That Rome remained so strong.
Man will be strong so long.
What is noble nowadays? Atheistic existentialism, which I represent, is more coherent. I do believe it.
Man is a complex of patterns, of processes.
There is no such thing as human nature, not in all or few men, since there is no God to conceive it.
Man is a complex of patterns, of processes. I live on Earth at present, and I don't know what I am. I know that I'm not a category. I'm not a thing. I'm now. I seem to be a verb, an evolutionary process, an integral function of the universe.
So in my lobby, I
retire. Thank you. to the vault.
But to complete. If any man, therefore, set aside even the least of the laws of man, he will have the lowest place in the kingdom of heaven. But if he keeps the law and teaches others, he will have the highest place in the kingdom of heaven. I tell you this unless you show yourselves far better men than the doctors of the law and the Pharisees. You shall never enter the kingdom of heaven. There once was a judge,
la la,
who cared nothing for God nor man,
la la.
And in the same town there was a widow who came before him demanding justice against her rival,
la la.
Well, for a long time he refused, but in the end he said to himself,
true, I can nothing for God nor man, but this widow is so great a nuisance that I will see her right before she wears me out with her persistence.
Now, you hear what the unjust judge says. And will God not vindicate his chosen, who cry out to him day and night, while he sits patiently listening to them?
Will he?
Oh, I tell you, he will vindicate all. When the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? I'm glad you brought that up.
Constable, and you lay in jail.
matter? You nursed it.
Yes.
Well, that's the answer. Time for a master. A master, you've got it, Randy.
Whoa.
I said the master.
Whoa.
But since the man had no means of paying the money, the master ordered him to be sold to me to death. With his wife.
Whoa.
Thank you. Master! Let me chastise the next man back there.
Now, if you might buy a vengeance, I want you to tear out and play it away.
Oh, no. It is better for you to lose one part of your body than for the whole of it to be thrown into hell.
No, but she's talking to you, right?
And
I want you to tear off and play it away.
Than for the whole of it to be thrown into hell. Now, you have learned that they were told an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But what I tell you is this. Never set yourself against a man who wrongs you. So, some blasphemy right to you.